handle students, able to stay encouraged, to stay positive, because during the lockdown, something that you've been encountering every time, this is so new to all of us, but then you've been given so much of time out of your all busyness, so utilize your time, do not waste your time, and stay positive all the time. As Kaitians, I want you people to be encouraging your family members as well, so that when the storm is passed away, we all will come out more stronger, more evolved, and more ready to face life's challenges. Okay, so with that note, I just want us to proceed on to Unit 4 of Digital Electronics. We have covered already 3 units of Digital Electronics. I just want to give a small recap on that. What is Unit 1 comprising of? It was about number systems, right? So number systems was all about like what kinds of number systems that we encounter in Digital Electronics other than the conventional ones. And then Unit 2 was about the combinational logic circuits. We had Digital Electronic devices being classified into combinational and sequential logic circuits, right? So again, that is what has been put here as a first title here about what is combinational logic circuit and what is a sequential logic circuit, right? So we know what a combinational logic circuit is. We dealt with adders, subtractors, the very basic devices of Digital Electronics, and then the multiplexers, the encoders, the decoders, the code converters, BCD to 7 segment, all that, right? I hope you all remember all that. So that was about combinational circuit, and defining the combinational logic circuit, it's nothing but the output value is going to be dependent on only the present state value of the input. So that was about combinational circuit. And what about sequential logic circuits? They are feedback systems. Hope you remember that. And the output is going to be dependent upon the present state as well as the sequence of the past inputs, that is the previous state outputs. So when we speak of sequential, we have to have a memory element. Memory is needed here, right? Because we want the previous or the past state to be stored so that we can have it given along with the present inputs. So all those, I think you can recollect. And a Unit 4 is comprising of synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuits. So where did we come across this term synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuits? It was in counters, right? The pattern in which we give the clock will define whether it's a synchronous circuit or a asynchronous circuit. So in the case of a synchronous circuit, the clock is synchronous. Clock is a train of pulses, right? So in the case of a synchronous circuit, the clock is given synchronously to all the flip-flops or the elements that are there in the circuit. Whereas in the case of asynchronous, only the first will be given a clock, and the consecutive ones are being triggered by the previous ones. That was the main difference between a synchronous and asynchronous. So here in the case of synchronous, a transition from one state to the other is by a synchronous clock, whereas in the case of asynchronous, not controlled by a single clock, that is the transition from one state to the other, whenever there is a logic change in the input to the circuit at any time, and this gives a higher speed in the case of asynchronous circuits. So moving on to the next one, what can we say about more defined about in the case of sequential circuits? What can we say about the sequential circuits? You can have a very good idea about it in the case of a sequential circuit. I'll just move to the next one. Yes. All the state variables are binary in nature. It's a digital system again. So we have all the state variables to be binary in nature. and if number of the state variables is going to be n, the relationship between the state variables and the possible states you know is 2 to the power n. So if we have n variables, you'll have 2 to the power n possible states. And even for larger values of n, the number of possible states is still finite, okay, in the case of sequential circuits. Therefore, sequential circuits are also referred to as FSMs, finite state machines. And here's a general sequential circuit model of a sequential circuit. We have a mixed state decoder, memory elements that will store the past or the previous states, and the output decoder. A mode, and we do have feedback connection. It's a sequential circuit. So from the memory element, the previous states that have been stored, they are fed back into the next state decoder. And again here in this case, the input variables are being fed into the output state decoder finally before giving out the outputs. And this is what has been shown here in this also. You can see that a model general sequential circuit diagram has been shown, and the present state of the circuit is stored in the memory element. The memory can be any device capable of storing information to specify the state of the circuit. If a sequential circuit has n states, then the memory should be storing in those n states. So we have always spoken about counters. You remember the counters. In case if it's going to be an n bit counter, we have to have n states so that we can process the n bit counter. N states, when I said n states, it was 2 to the power n states. And if it's an n bit counter, we know a single flip flop will process a single bit information. So hope things are clear there. Only then it will be understandable. And in the case of the mixed state of the circuit, it is determined by the present state of either inputs. It's a sequential circuit, a feedback system. So this is mandatory in a sequential logic circuit. The function of the mixed state decoder logic is to decode the external inputs and the present state of the circuit stored in the memory, that is a code called as the mixed state variable. And the mixed state variable will become loads and stores them, and this process would be called as a state change. Where we did the design of a counter, we drew a state transition diagram. Hope you remember that, a state transition diagram that signifies the counter one sequence to the other sequence and what exactly has to be the excitation in them to the counter so as to have that kind of transition. Hope you can recollect that. And the mixed state variable will become the present state when the memory loads and stores them. And this is also called as a state change or state transition. When we drew the state transition diagram, again, we had a transition taking place. And whenever we drew the table of present state, mixed state, and this is the mixed state, during the next case, the mixed state would become the present state. You can recollect, I hope. And then the state changing is going to be a continuous process with a new set of inputs and each new set being able to form the new state variables, right? So every time there is a change in the present and the decoded information being given, the new next state will be formed. Now the sequential circuit is a feedback system, as we have already seen here. It acts along with inputs to determine the next state. So there's a continuous state transition, and this is going to be called as present state state transition, right? And how we get that? It is being determined by the present state of the machine and also possibly by the to the circuit. Yes, the input plays a role along with the present state, which has been the previous state. The form of the output decoder is to record the present state of the machine and the present inputs for generating the desired outputs, and the output of a synchronous machine may be clocked just as the function is being. Finite state machine may be clocked just as the state transition is also being. Have a good classification here, And about the classification, I'll read in the next. We have class A, class B, class C, class D, and class E. We'll deal about this in the video. Thank you so much.